Hey there everybody, so today I spent a good amount of time working on my Medulce debt. For those of you who don't know, I live out here in Seattle, and we just had a regional last weekend where a duelist named Alexander Thomas took first with Medulce. So we beat out Evil Swarms and Prophecies and Elemental Dragons with Medulce, and so I took a long look at his build, and I've retooled mine, and I'm giving all the credit to some of these techs to him, because he really knows his stuff, and he topped back in September, and that had inspired me to originally build Medulce. So if he watches this, thank you for all the help. Alright, so this is my build, and I'll explain why I did a couple little things different than his build. So, one copy of Medulce Princess. I love Medulce Princess. I think she's awesome. Her effect is pretty fun, just getting to destroy extra cards. And she combos really well with Medulce Knights, which I like to play. So, yeah, I like Princess. Three copies of Medulce Magdalene. Stratos Searcher, awesome. Two copies of Medulce Hootcakes. I really don't think you need to run three of Hootcakes, because you don't always have monsters in the graveyard, but you can set up a lot of cool plays with Hootcakes, and he just really makes the deck great. So, two copies of Medulce Messagelato. I was at three, and I've gone down to two. There are some times that I do wish I still had three, because, you know, he gets overlaid and stuff, but and then you want to bring him out more. But, you know, I can get away with him at two, and that means I have room for other things in the deck. Two copies of Medulce Mewful. This is a difference between my deck and Alexander Thomas's deck. He only runs one Mewful, I run two. I really like having Mewful in hand. I have a lot of times where I can set up cool plays with Mewful and Hootcakes for Mewful and Messagelato, Mewful and Pudding Sus. So I personally like having two. That's my choice. Two copies of Max C. Why? Well, basically because I don't have three. I'm still looking for a third Max C. So as soon as I get a third, I'll be upping this to three, but for now, it's just going to be at two. Two copies of Effect Veiler. This is pretty much what I've kind of settled on, is going with Effect Veiler over Drolan Lock in my main deck. Two copies of Guardian Yatos. Combos really, really well with Hootcakes. I can't believe that I forgot about Yatos. When I originally built Medulce the first time, I tried teching in Yatos, and he didn't work out well, so I pulled him out, and yeah, now with Hootcakes, he's a lot better, so like him, just being able to drop it. And then this is, this Kaiku the Ghost Destroyer is some tech that, once again, was played by Alexander Thomas, and I personally think it's an awesome tech card. Just really messes with the current meta decks, and I just like Kaiku. I've always liked Kaiku. Alright. On the spells, I got two copies of Medulce Chateau. Alexander Thomas only played one Medulce Chateau, and it started making me think, you know, do I really need to run three Chateaus the way that I can search out cards with Hootcakes now? And I don't think I do, but I still like Chateau a lot, mainly the attack bonus that it gives me lets me get over so much, and just the general advantage it gets by bouncing stuff back to my hand. So I don't want to play without two, so I'm going to keep it at two, but I don't think it's necessary to have three now, because of the way it can be recycled, and because of how quickly it can be searched out. Two copies of Medulce Ticket. Pretty much always run two Ticket. One copy of Book of Moon. Two copies of Mystical Space Typhoon. MST gets rid of back row, and bottom line for me is that the best cards that I've found, like the cards that shut me down and mess with me the most, are things like Skill Drain or Macrocosmos, you know. So if I can just take out those cards, those face-up cards, I need back row destruction. Two copies of Forbidden Lance. Because it's Lance. Two copies of Nidolche Knights. I love Nidolche Knights. It is just wonderful. Spell speed 3 negates the activation of an effect. Hit, you know, the cards that, you know, it doesn't matter where the effect is activating at, it can negate it. As long as you don't have any monsters in your graveyard. So it does require you to, like, you have to know what you're doing in order to play Nidolche Knights, and you have to, like, have yourself set up to be able to use Nidolche Knights. But I think it's awesome. And there's been a lot of times, especially like mid to late game, when I still have my graveyard clear and I can hit Nidolche Knights and just be like, oh, by the way, that's game. Yeah. One copy of Nidolche Palooza. I love Palooza. Palooza sets up OTKs. One copy of Ultimate Offering, just way too good with things like Magellan. Two copies of Mirror Force. Two copies of Bottomless. Two copies of Threatening Roar. I love Threatening Roar, this format. I just think it's an amazing card because it's a chainable trap, so, you know, as soon as you set it, it's pretty much live, and it guarantees you another turn. Unless you are going to get Cowboyed to Death, in which case, no, you're going to lose anyway. Three copies of Compulse. This just screws it up so much. It's a chainable trap. I can combo with it to get my stuff back, so yeah, I love Compulse. And finally, one copy of Scrap Iron Scarecrow, again, same thing. Alexander Thomas raved about this card, and I tested it today with some friends, and yeah, Scrap Iron Scarecrow, it puts in work. So that's the main deck, and then extra deck, rank 3s. I've got one copy of Wind of Zen Means, one copy of Levier the Sea Dragon, one copy of MX Saber Invoker. That's it for my rank 3s. A lot of rank 4s. Two copies of Dolce Queen Tiramisu. You know, obviously, Tiramisu is the one who I'm going to bring out, you know, 9 times out of 10 when I see someone. It's going to be for her, and it's going to be to wreck. One copy of Shockmaster. I hardly ever go into Shockmaster in this deck, but I still like to have it around just in case. One copy of Photon Pappy Operative. One copy of Stroke. One copy of Number 39 Utopia. One copy of Utopia Ray. One copy of Blade Armor Ninja, just because I can go ahead and overlay the two Message Gelatos into a Blade Armor Ninja and do a ton of damage. One copy of Diamond Direwolf. I like Diamond Direwolf, and, you know, I run double Muleful, and I've got the two Hoot Cakes, so, like, those are targets for a Direwolf. One copy of Geiger Cowboy. One copy of Abyss Dweller. And then the last card that I have here in my extra deck is Degusto Emerald. And this is one that Alexander Thomas did not have in his deck. And he said when he was, like, showing off his extra deck in the video that I watched, that he, you know, he didn't summon most of the Xyz monsters in his deck. And so, for me, I was really surprised that he didn't have Degusto Emerald, because I personally go into Emerald almost every duel. Emerald helps keep my graveyard clear. He's a, like a mini Pot of Avarice, and I don't run Pot of Avarice. So, I mean, like, if I had to pick the MVPs out of my extra deck, it's going to be Emerald, Abyss Dweller, my two Tiramisus, my Invoker, and my Levier. Like, these are the six cards in my extra deck that I summon almost all the time. So I don't understand how you can go without, like, Emerald, who keeps your graveyard clear. Like, Levier, I love going into Levier for the same reason I go into Invoker. You know, it's just a matter of what you already have in your graveyard, what you're removing from play for Hootcake's effect. So that's my deck. Hope you like it. Hope you think it's cool. I think everybody should try Medulla Chase because they're a lot of fun and they're really cute. So.